was just watching the documentary on Lena Horne. And she did a thing called St. Louis Blues or something like that. Noble Sister in County Color, whatever happened. And I'm heading to St. Louis, so naturally, whatever happens, this is where I'm at. But I'm on a train going to St. Louis. It's the last leg. It was one train took me to someplace. One train from New York Penn Station to Indianapolis. Okay, and then I got off Indianapolis and took a bus to Bloomington Normal, and then from Bloomington Normal now I'm on this bus to this train to St. Louis. But it's interesting because I think when I go to the APUS conference in Louisville, I think I must take that same first leg from the train to from New York to Indianapolis, because you get off the bus there. You get off the train, you get on the bus, it's like 2 hours to Louisville, right? Otherwise, you got to do the whole little chain. Then, of course, you have the Chinese bus for $90, but I love train travel, so I'd rather take the train. But, train can't walk, this kind of stuff. Like, I have my sun chips, a big bag of chips, but then I have some of it, but, on the thing. And also, what else I got here? I got my Trader Joe's bag, insulated bag. I got stuff there. I don't know if you know what I have here. Some other stuff. Oh, when I left New York, there was I just wandered around before that. I kept getting the train left, but six, ten in the morning, but I'll be like 4:30 somewhere else. And I was wandering around. Fortunately for me, see, I like dark chocolate, and I ran into a store and they had milk, they had M&M dark. Here the thing is, you can't find M&M dark in a lot of places, so I had to get it. And then they also had Dove dark with cherries. So, come on, I didn't have a choice. I want my check, plenty of things, but I need that wrong. Ooh, that's what I can remember before I do that. Let me find my, in my bag here, let me find my, my glasses. I'll put on my glasses for you guys. There you go. Put on my glasses. Suck on them. Hey, I look famous. Let me take my things off. That's better. What else did I do? Oh, and on the other train, I had this weird thing. You know, it's like, I like the support, you know? But, water and that stuff costs too much on the train. So I had bought my own water, right? And the first leg of the train was like a 21-hour, 21 hours, something like that. So I was going to buy that, all that expensive water on the train. But it did break down at the end. And that night, I did, which is not advisable. You shouldn't do this. You shouldn't really, I shouldn't say that. I got some red wine, Cabernet Sauvignon. Hey, what can I tell you, red wine? But I didn't drink that much, because I really don't, it's a small bottle. And I usually drink like this, like a half a thing right now. I'm not even drinking it right now. When I get to JB, that's my friend, then I probably drink something tonight, but I'll put it in a proper wine glass. So I get there. And then, okay, here's the thing. Here's the other thing that happened. So when I was in this place, this normal place, let me see. I took the bus and I went at the Bloomington Normal, right? And I was there. I didn't. Okay, here's what happened. I was wondering about my bag that I had checked in. I checked in like I left on the 25th, but I checked in my bag on the 24th, right? And so what happened was when I got to at the Cardinal, I just checked to see if my bag was there. They didn't have the bag in that train, so I got a little antsy because, they gave me a tag that went through to St. Louis, right? So I didn't know if you're supposed to have the bag on that train, then you're supposed to take the bag off and put it on the bus and follow you like that. Or what? So when I got here, I just checked with them, and they called, and then they found out that Oh no, they sent the bag a day early because they basically went to Chicago and then came down, then come down to St. Louis. But that initial train on is actually a Chicago train. But I don't know. Anyway, most of my bags should be in St. Louis. Well, it is in St. Louis, that's what they said. They were going to have it. And when I was at that normal place, and I was walking through and checking on that stuff, they had a thing from the library. They just had a book exchange, whatever have you. So I picked up The God of Small Things, Aaron Dottie Roy. Now, this must mean, it might mean after, you know, this is about Kerala, India, southern, southwestern part of India. I usually am in the south, eastern part, that's Tamil Nadu is usually there, but you know, I've been to Kerala, nothing but coconuts and intellectuals in Kerala. Anyway, but Aaron Dottie Roy, a very famous writer, she's an activist, whatever happened. But I had started, when I was in India, was it the last time? I was in India sometime. I did this play, and in this play that I was directing, my stage manager was a vociferous reader, right? And so, she was reading this book, and so I started to read it right before I left, but I couldn't read the whole thing, so I had left it in Oral, not this book, not this copy of the book, but this book. I left it at Errolville, at the guest house I was at, you know. But I told the person that was there, that my stage manager at the time, that was there, whatever, I told him, I said, you know, if I ever see Aaron Dottie Roy, you know, I'll say hello. Now, there's billions of people in India, so the likelihood of running into Aaron Dottie Roy, you know, I'm down on myself, was just not likely. But anyway, so I went up to New Delhi on that trip, and I met a friend of when we work Democracy Now!, one of the producers there, Kennedy, she was there, so I stayed with her for a couple of days, because this is like a journalistic friend. I told her so before, a long time ago. And so, but what happened was we went out to dinner, you know, all these journalists. Now, journalists, you know, her boyfriend wrote for the biggest English-speaking newspaper in India. You know, there was some television producers there, and so, you know, so we were just talking. And I said, yeah, you know, blah, blah, but, you know, I told about the book I left, you know, if I would see Aaron Dottie Roy, I'm supposed to say hello and tell him about the book. And then so he says, oh, well, she's right over there. So I'm going like, I'm no sucker, you know what I'm saying? So I said, yeah, sure. I said, no, she's right over there. Because, you know, journalists, you know, the people, they always, you know, jostle each other. They said, no, look, she's right over there. And I looked over there, sure enough, Aaron Dottie Roy was sitting there with a couple of people having dinner. Now, remember, I started my little career at Ningbo Ensemble Company, so I'm used to famous people, and I never go up to people and say, oh, blah, 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 blah. But I couldn't. I just had to do it. But when we went on our way out, I just, you know, my husband, excuse me, I really mean to interrupt, but I have to tell you this story. I was reading your book, you know, but I couldn't finish it, and I didn't want to take it away, so it's down there at New Creations Guest House. So if you're ever there, just sign that copy of your book, please. That's all I did, right? But think about that. That's a full circle story that I want to tell you. Anyway, we're on a lovely train ride. Right now, we're going through Illinois. Right now, we're going through Illinois. We're on our way to Missouri and St. Louis. And, well, I'll talk to you another time. Thanks for listening. This is just a message from me, T for the Patterson. Forgive the shaking. T for the Patterson, take me train to the bed. Let you know what I only suspect. Even though it's not a death from the ADOS, but I'm going to create, you know, the deaths of the ADOS as soon as I get to, you know, where I'm going to in Kirkwood. Where Kirkwood lives? Yeah, Kirkwood. Where?